Hello everyone and welcome to this tutorial. I'm so excited to have you here. My name is Peggy Kemeka. I'm from the University of Yaoundé in Cameroon. This video is the follow-up of my first tutorial entitled The Shape of Data, whose the link of the video is given in the description below. In that tutorial, we have seen this pipeline up to find the shape of data through homology. Finding the shape of data is all about extracting knowledge from data, and we would like to remind that the shape of data is very useful to make prediction, to do statistical analysis, and it's also useful in topological machine learning to enhance machine learning algorithm to do some artificial intelligence tasks. In fact, we would like to improve the performance of machine learning algorithm that would have performed poorly if fed with raw data. So the explanation of this pipeline is the following. I start with data that I then approximate the shape by drawing ball around each data point with a certain ratio R, such that when K plus one balls intercept, we build a K simplex. By doing so, for all possible value of radia, we will have an increasing sequence of patterns called filtration, like this one here. Then we find the pattern that persists the most, the pattern that persists for a wide range of radia. For example, on this data, let's assume that this is the pattern that has persisted the most. His homology will just reveal to us the shape of this data. Let us say that the notion of shape can really, really improve the performance of machine learning algorithm. And we also would like to say that the powerful tool hidden behind this pipeline is called persistent homology, and it will be explained soon. But before that, let us set our objective. The task of this present video is to use our TDA pipeline in the practical setting to find the shape of a real-world data, namely the average monthly temperature in Cameroon. Our data are coming from Berkeley Health data page, and it is on this format. Here are the first 11 heads. Our data has three variables, the date, the average temperature, and the country. In this tutorial, we will mainly use some R packages like deploy and TDA. The problem is the following. Just imagine that due to the impact of climate change in Cameroon, you have been hired to find the temperature pattern in Cameroon. The point is to find the shape of the temperature data in Cameroon so that it can enable the Cameroon government to make smart decisions to better manage climate change. Cameroon is a country in Central Africa. Here is the map of Africa. Here is the map of Cameroon. In the first analysis, when we observe our data, it looks very noisy and very scattered. Therefore, conventional models like linear regression and clustering cannot fit our data. Moreover, if we think of neural network models, which are the type of machine learning inspired by the structure of a human brain, this sounds a pretty good idea. But afterward, we will have to deal with overfitting, because you might end up getting a shape that does not generalize the data well. Therefore, we need a method that let the data to tell the story. That let the data to express itself, and that let the data to do it without requiring any hypothesis. And this is when persistent homology comes into play. So what is persistent homology? It's an algebraic method for discerning topological feature of data. By topological feature, we mean n-dimensional whole. For example, the idea of persistent homology on this data is to study the evolution of the associated filter complex K here from I to I plus 3 by keeping track of the birth and death of cycle classes. So the persistent K homology of the complex Ki is given by this formula too. For example, the persistent first homology between I and I plus 2, it is this cycle up. In fact, according to this formula, I should look at the cycle that are created at time I, here at the cycle, and then I should remove the one that have become boundary. So I should remove this one, and I will be left with this one up. This one down is no part of the competition because it was not created at time I. So persistent homology enables us to know exactly when a cycle is created and when it dies. And this is then summarized and stored in a combinatorial way in a diagram called persistent diagram, which is a final multi-set of points in a plane above the diagonal. Here is the definition too. In the persistent diagram, a point has a x-coordinate, which represents when a cycle is created, and a y-coordinate, which represents when a cycle dies. For example, on this filtration, this cycle here is created at time y. So y represents his x-coordinate, and it dies at time I plus 2. So I plus 2 represents its y-coordinate. So a point with his x-coordinate and y-coordinate represent a generator of the homology of the chosen dimension. Loosely speaking, a point represents a hole of a chosen dimension. And this persistent diagram is going to be one of the key elements on our methodology, which is given as follows. We start with the raw data that we then pre-process to have a clean data. When we have the clean data, we do data transformation to have the TDA ready data. When we have our TDA ready data, we apply TDA method to have our persistent diagram from which we extract two features, the periodicity score and the persistent landscape. And both features will help us to do classification and to make prediction. So when we are talking about pre-processing our data, we actually mean dealing with missing value. We also mean find the filtration that, let's say, find the feature that we are interested in. For example, we find the feature Cameroon in the data that we presented above. When we find the feature by filtering our data, like, and we get the variable Cameroon, it remains only one thing: deal with noise on our data. When we deal with noise by using moving average, we have a clean data, and this is the time series associated to that clean data. So the cleaning process is done with the function omic, filter, select, and moving average of some R packages like deploy. When we have our clean data, we then apply data transformation to have the data that we can apply TDA method on. We mean that to get a point cloud. So for data transformation, we have used sliding window embedding. There are several tutorials on this channel that explain sliding window embedding. If you observe our point cloud now, you can remark that it has changed. It's no more the point cloud that we had at the beginning. This is because we have removed noise on our data during the cleaning process. When we have our TDA ready data, which is the point cloud that we presented, we apply our TDA method, which is persistent homology, to have this persistent diagram. So in the persistent diagram, the points that are far away from the diagonal represent true features, and the ones that are close to the diagonal are regarded as noise. So the further apart the point are from the diagonal, the higher the persistent is. From this persistent diagram, we extracted the feature called score of periodicity using this formula. This is the formula of the score of periodicity, where B and D are the birth and the death of the one dimensional homology that exists the most. We can see that our score of periodicity is 0.203. Thus, the time series data that we have is periodic. Another feature that we have extracted is called persistent landscape. The advantage of this other feature is that it can be easily associated with the tool from machine learning and statistics. Persistent landscape is just the collection of a function lambda defined as follows, with lambda kt equal k max of p of lambda pt, where k max is the k largest value, and lambda of pt is given with this mathematical formula. Let us remind that this persistent landscape was first proposed by Peter Bubenyik and implemented by Powell Dolko. When we observe our first persistent landscape, we can see that it is very significant, a proof that we are dealing with a periodic signal. So in conclusion, based on our analysis, the temperature of Cameroon has a cyclic behavior, but it is too noisy. We can see that we have used persistent homology to find the shape of our data. And in summary, we can say that in this tutorial, we have presented a topological analysis-based method to detect the shape of data, namely the shape of the temperature data in Cameroon. We have seen that the temperature data in Cameroon has a periodic behavior. This allows us to know the climatic pattern in Cameroon. The presented methodology is of general nature and may be used whenever there is a suspected periodic behavior in time series. In the future tutorial, we plan to build a predictive system that allows monthly weather forecasts in Cameroon, taking into account persistent homology information. Here are our references, and thank you for watching this tutorial. Feel free to ask any question. Bye-bye.